We talk. We are live every day on Kick from around 4 to 2 in the morning, Mountain Standard Time. So that's 2 hours behind East Coast time. So that's basically like I'm live from 6 to 4 every day, East, if we're going off for Eastern time. Pull up to the stream, link is in the bio. Don't forget to like, subscribe, share, notifies. We don't sleep. Say just dropped another video on Nick in the fucking cut. It's scumbag. Everybody go shout out to Say. Big shout out to Say Harmony Sum. And the video titled The Truth About Nickinthecutt is 30 minutes. Let's just get into it. Oh, nah.
Ever since I was a chick, and why was it shit? Shawty keep running, come round, she wanna get hit.
She thinks she done made me, cause I keep having my side. Double up, bust on her watch, she know that I'm timeless.
I put my son in some red.
Yes, sir!
Did this nigga just finish making a TikTok? What the fuck?
Alright, let's start this shit off by saying, fuck you, pussy. You got your ass exposed, bitch. Oh, nah. Fuck you. The first time I met him was in the college bulletin. I did stream smack him.
Yo, put the chat in.
And
holy.
I met him, you know who I was already and shit. No, we did the stream. You know, everything went well. His chat likes me. He asked me off stream, who have you collaborated with before? And I was like, Kenny. My boy Kenny, he was like, I don't fuck with him. I'm like, alright. And I asked him why. He was like, it's his ego. And like, me personally, like if I see him, I wouldn't walk up to him and dap him up unless he came to me. I was like, alright, not my problem. They wanted him beating him.
Alright.
The next day, Friday, he invited me to
that's kind of weird. Like, that's kind of weird to just say that. Alright.
On the stream at Seaside. This is day two. We went to Seaside, you know? We did the stream with Nate and everyone while he's still cool with Nate. We did the stream, everything went well. That's day two of meeting him. I was in the car, like, kind of...
I see the fucking time, too. W streaming, man. 3 a.m. We bussing.
A little awkward, a little quiet.
Because
I don't know any one of them, you know? And then at the end of the stream, he said, you should pull up to the Bay Area tour to stream and stuff. I was like, all right, bet I'm down. His chat loves me and shit. His chat want me to be a part of the team. But like, all right, bet, sure. So fast forward a week later, he hit me up. He called me, actually. He was like, yo, bro, you still down to go to the tour? I was like, yeah, 100%. I'm down, bro. Like, I'm being serious. I'm down, bro. And then day three, meeting him in person. So basically day three, we were IRL stream at Long Beach College, Cal State Long Beach. The whole stream went well, everything was good. And then it was like, yo, you want me to go to your house so I could pick up my stuff, like my clothes and stuff for the tour? I was like, nah, you good, bro. I'll get dropped off by your house. I left home, he went home. Everything went well still, you know? I thought he was chill and shit. All right, cool. It was day three of meeting him in person. All right, cool. He was chill and shit. And then that same night, like it was like around 9 when I arrived at his house. His cameraman opened the door. And then it was not even welcoming, you feel me? I wasn't expecting much too, but it was just like he opened the door and he left upstairs. Like me not knowing where the fuck to put my shit. And yeah, I wasn't tripping about that either. Alright, so I'm at his house. It's day three. This is his first time lying to me. He said he was gonna go get food, but he ended up bringing a girl over. And it was this girl right here that I'm gonna roll the clip.
Would you ever... Oh, okay, that's a good...
So after he bring her over, he got her to suck his shit, whatever the fuck. They all left. He dropped her off at a party. And then, you know, we went to get food. He was just talking about girls, like how they're being hoes and shit. Like, don't ever fucking marry no girl or like cuffed up or stay with one. Always have others because, bro, you're not gonna be good with one girl. I was like, all right, haha. Like, just I'm not taking this shit serious. I'm just thinking he was just trolling, right? But in reality, he was being serious about it. Later that day when we went back home, we left straight to his house. And then we took an 8-hour drive towards Sacramento. He was just talking about like his trip with this one girl from Japan. I think the girl is this right here, whatever. This girl right here. He was just talking about her, how like she's being fucking annoying. It was his worst like trip of his life, his worst 1 week of his life. Oh, check him out, like
he dirty Mac,
fuck that bitch. This bitch is a fucking thot. Like
he dirty Mac and OD. He calling out all the bitches too. Oh nah, he fucking up the whole bag for everything after he fucked them up. I see the play. You not low.
This bitch is a fucking whore. How she's trying to fuck NFL players. How she bragged about her shit. But he's talked shit about her. I don't know the full story. This is the second time talking shit about someone. And then on the same ride, the same 8-hour drive, he was talking about his homeboy Nate that they recently got in a fight with, like the day before the Bay Area trip, how he left to film for Jeremy Cain full time, and how Nate backstabbed him, and like how he betrayed him, cause he was like, I was the reason why he met Jerry and did this shit for him. And look at what he fucking did. He stabbed me behind my back. So he basically saying, I'm his replacement. Like, keep talking shit about Nate, how like he's lazy. He hotboxed his car. Like, he could bring girls to his house, but can't even do like some of the work that Nick paid for. I'm like, yeah, sure, I guess that makes sense. That was his third time talking shit about someone, like, off camera. It wasn't really off camera.
So he talking shit about girls he's with. He's talking shit about his closest friends. Oh, this nigga's a snake. Oh, this nigga's just a snake, chat. Yo, chat, I'm about to trip in. This nigga's just a snake. Yo, this nigga's a bozo.
Because I filmed a vlog the whole trip. Like, everything was filmed with this camera. That's going on to day 4. So we arrive at the hotel, and then for 2 days, the minorities came over to the hotel and they filmed a document, whatever. Cool. After the minorities left, next morning, it was basically like a rest day, like just rest, basically.
Oh God,
and then later that day, we took a drive to Nevada. It was like 2 hours, right? And before we took a drive, Nick basically dropped us off at a random Asian anime shop, whatever, Boba, what the fuck. We just sat there for like 3 hours waiting for him because he wanted to go see a girl, and then he did whatever the fuck he did with her for like 3 hours. He came back. Isaac, his cameraman, was tight. Like, bro, I can't do shit, bro. I hate sitting around for 3 hours waiting for you, bro. And then they were just arguing back and forth. Everything was filmed on my camera, on this camera right now. Everything was filmed, but I just tell you why I don't have the footage. We took a 2-hour drive later in the night towards Nevada, right? And then we got there to the hotel. During the 2-hour trip, he was just still talking shit about Nate, and then like the Jimmy Zhang drama and shit. And then the cameraman had issue with the Jimmy Zhang dude, whatever. And then he was just talking about like how he fucked up Nick's image, because there was a clip of Nick saying like, why this bitch ain't turning her camera on a live stream, and people clipped it and sent it to Jason, whatever. And Jason saw it, and Jason wasn't really fucking with that shit. And then he was like, this is the reason why I couldn't film a documentary on Jason, bro. Like, fuck, bro. And he's like, he was just talking shit about everyone. But I have no idea what the story about. We were just talking shit, right? So we got there late in the night at a hotel.
Yeah, and I ain't gonna lie.
He was calling
we successfully broke it into Asian streaming Twitch and TikTok. Let's go. Big dubs in the chat. Everybody, let's go. So why y'all laughing? That's not funny, bro. Why y'all laughing, bro?
Quote, girlfriend, funny, nigga. Talking about like, oh, hey, babe, whatever. I love you, whatever. Like, basically, like manipulating her, saying like you're the only one and shit. Like, while, like, not even 3 hours ago, he was just fucking with another girl. Right, cool, bro. Whatever. And then the next morning, we woke up. We went to the tailgate to stream. We did that, and then we were straight from there, we drove to his quote-unquote girlfriend house, the one he said he loved her and shit. And then he was in the car talking about, like, bro, if I didn't get these hoes on my phone, we wouldn't have 7 days to stay over for a week for free, bro. You saved up money talking to these hoes. And, like, just the way he talked about females, just, like, crazy. I was like, haha, like, I was just trying to agree with him, but, like, obviously, I don't know them like that. I'm just, so we got there at his quote-unquote girlfriend house. He left with her to go out to eat or something, while me and Isaac just stayed home, just, like, to play cards and shit. Everything that I said was already recorded, because I asked him before anything, like, to vlog the whole trip, and he was like, yeah, sure. So this is day 7, whatever. It was on a Monday. We woke up. And then we went straight.
Okay, so he's not snaking him. So even, let's say, even if they was, like, still friends, he's not snaking him because, like, he asked them. WMATS.
To stream out of college. We did that. You came back home. There was whole footage about, like, me and Nick was just talking shit about basketball, like, as jokes and, like, as, like, competitiveness because they were playing 2K and stuff. Everything was filmed, right? Tuesday was a rest day, talking about, like, we should do something on Tuesday, tomorrow, whatever. Because we had nothing planned and it's supposed to be a rest day. But, like, we already took so much rest. And, like, he already seen the amount of views. And, like, if we stream every day and the consistency is good, it's going to skyrocket. Me and Isaac says the same thing. And we came up with an idea saying, like, we should do this one idea on stream where we all wear PJs and then going around, like, asking girls if they want to join our club, our professional cuddling club, with our PJs. It would be funny on stream, whatever, for entertainment, right? He was like, bro, that's some dumbass idea. Like, he'd straight up say that, dumbass idea, bro. And I was like, bro, wow, what the fuck? Like, in my head, I was like, what the fuck? Like, we're just trying to make new ideas to stream tomorrow because we're just trying to grind. And then bro was like, bro, that's some dumbass idea, bro. Ain't nobody want to watch that shit. And then he was like, bro, that shit not gonna be good, bro. That shit not gonna be good. Me and Isaac was saying it was gonna be good. Like, we should try it. You know, it doesn't hurt to try. And he was like,
honestly, bro, like, you'd be surprised, like, how much people on Twitch would find that entertaining, bro. Like, a lot of the shit we don't think would entertain chat actually entertains chat, bro. I mean, like, just you sitting there and just talking with your friends interchange chat because, like, they want to see that. And I never thought that, but that changed my perspective, bro. Like, I used to have old segments early in the year doing that. I'm going to start that back up.
I don't want to do that shit. If the idea is really that good, y'all can do that shit. I was like, damn, bro. The fuck? We're just trying to get new ideas. Like, the fuck is you, like, pressing about? It's talking about, like, hang on some petty ass shit. Like, bro, if your idea was so good, why don't you do it? Where's your 1 million viewers at? Where's your 300,000 viewers at? If that shit was so good. And before anything, like, before I told Nick about the idea, Isaac told me that, like, bro, he not gonna do it, bro. Because he does what he want to do, and he don't like taking advice or new ideas in. And then it was true, bro. He was being petty. I was like, damn, bro. Like, I kind of see the type of person he really is a little bit about this shit. Like, he was just pressing me about that shit. I was like, I just kept my mouth shut. And then the next morning, on Tuesday, we woke up. Me and woke up, like, kind of late, at, like, 11:50. He walked out. He was like, why are you guys still here? Since your idea was so good, why are you guys still here? Why won't you go stream it? Me and Isaac was like, bro, we want to do it as a group. But he didn't want to. He was like, why are you guys still here? Like, go do it, bro. If that shit was so good.
Damn, is that deep?
Later that day on Tuesday, he was on a call. He FaceTimed Nate. He was talking about like, yo, what's good, Nate? How's Philly with Jarrett? Like, how's it over there? And so, like, on some homie, best friend type of combo, right? But then, just not even yesterday or 2-3 days ago, he was just talking shit about him. But on a FaceTime call, it's on some chill shit, trolling Isaac, like on some best friend shit, whatever. And then me and Isaac, that night, it was like around 1 a.m., I asked Isaac, like, yo, bro, why does Nick do that? And Isaac was like, do what? Like, acting all cool and shit in front of Nate, but behind his back, he talks shit about him, like, a lot. Isaac was like, bro, I don't know, bro, that shit is kind of weird. I'm like, bro, don't you think that's on some fake-ass shit? He was like, yeah, but that's just some, that is weird, not gonna lie. I don't know why he do that. That's what Isaac said, right? And then we went to sleep. The next morning, we woke up, took an hour drive to Berkeley. We did a stream, and he met my brother because, you know, he dropped off a hoodie and stuff. We drove back home. He was still just talking shit about, like, the Jimmy Zhang and fucking, we couldn't collab with Jason Lee. That's all he fucking talked about in his brain cells. So we did that. That was Wednesday. The next day is on Thursday. We woke up. That's the day when we went to the college. We were just trying to raise up girls, like, normally, like, how we always do in colleges. And then we went to eat. Since we have, like, five hours left, let's go hoop. Earlier, on the day we arrived at his girlfriend's house, we were playing 2K and shit, like, talking shit. How who's better at basketball, whoever, me and him, who's better at basketball. And we shook each other's hand like, all right, let's put $20 on it, say less. So that was on Monday. I was like way before, and I brought the idea back up, like, oh, we should hoop, like,
hoop. That doesn't work.
Hoop.
Bust your ass.
He wouldn't bust my ass,
chat. They've been talking, hold on, they've been talking crazy for the past week about who's good and who's not good at basketball. It's a bet. Y'all putting money on it?
Yeah, 20.
20?
50.
Fuck. I don't got bread. Basically, getting my milk.
I gotta get my shoes.
I'll put...
What shoes?
Let me side bet. I'll put 22.
On who?
Nick. It's my dog.
You better not. Let's go play basketball then. Let's go play basketball.
Hold on, my dad calling me.
We went to Dick's Sporting Good. We got the shoes. Got the shoes, he got his shorts, whatever.
Fuck Curry.
What?
Yeah.
You about to get fucking fried.
Fuck Curry?
Mm-hmm.
Really? Yeah, I'm gonna do the Curry on you. Shooting that shit in your mouth.
Right.
And then we went to Best Buy to grab the mic, cause.
So why they couldn't keep it like this, bro? Just shit talking, banter, like, even let's say bro called that mad, like, bad L. Bro, Nick, you could have just, like, laughed it off and said, bro, I ain't gonna lie, you got me today. I just gotta get back in the gym. I'll come back for you, but you whooped my ass today. I laughed it off. Nigga wouldn't have looked at you bad. Nigga would say, okay, yeah, it's a cut ass. You would have probably went viral for that cut ass, but it's basketball at the end of the day. Feel me? And you could really just have, like, a whole redemption arc on some flight shit and just milk that story. Feel me? So... Oh no, man. Doing all that extra shit and giving yourself a big L, which sounds like you took two big L's, because I'm hearing about this, like, he had, like, some mini beef with some other dude in the Asian community and Jason. So,
man. I hope with the mic on, strapped up to our shit.
Put that out bad.
So come in the morning.
So we did that. We grabbed the mic. We went to 24 Hour Fitness. And then we played the ones. And obviously... Like, the whole raw footage is out on the internet. His bitch ass basically exposed himself. Like, he not only played basketball dirty as fuck, like, he talked shit about my family, about my brother. And then he talked shit about, like, what I did. Like, I'm a TikToker, bro. Like, trying to talk down on me. And then he bragged about his money and, like, talking shit about Kenny, who I collaborated with. It was just a bunch of shit. And I mean, you could see it in the whole raw footage. Like, he was just talking shit. And then he just kept touching me and shit. And by the way, during the stream, I said, let me guess, you gonna delete the VOD, huh? You gonna delete the VOD. And I kept pressing him, and then he got his ass whooped. Shit's embarrassing. So after everything, we drove back home. It was silent, but not really, because Isaac was trolling, like reading fake Twitch chat, like fake comments, talking shit, like dick riding Nick, basically saying, like, yo, say hit like a tablet, kid. And then Nick was like, yeah, I agreed. And they both laugh and shit.
They said you punch like an iPad kid. They said, say punches like an iPad kid.
And then I was like, the fuck? Like, where does it say? Where does it say that? And then Nick told Isaac to cut the stream and put it into clips. And then, like, a minute later, Nick was like, yo, I don't fuck with you no more. What? How the fuck you gonna say, talk all this shit, started everything, lost in both times, lost both fight, and saying he don't wanna fuck me? You didn't even shake my hand, bro. Like, the fuck? He said, I don't.
Can't expect everybody to be real. Can't expect everybody to move like you. I mean, that's what I learned in life, bro, in the stream and shit, too. For me. You probably gonna see it play out a couple more times in life. It's just now, hopefully, you prepared and you gonna see, like, the pattern start to, like, unfold.
I don't fuck with you anymore. I was like, bro, what the fuck? Why does it look like this? Isaac looked confused too, bro. And then we went home, play basketball. The stream cut back on. Isaac turned on the stream, and then he was admitting that he was glazing Nick a little bit. The fuck? No, you weren't glazing Nick a little bit. Admit that he was glazing and shit. And then Nick came outside. They both trying to like say, yo, bro,
the balls.
Just come to the club on some chill shit, bro. Like, they're trying to gaslight me to go after all that, all this true, his true color got exposed towards everyone. And he got shit rocked. And then he was like, man, I don't fuck with you, but let's just go to the club on some chill shit. I was like, fuck no. Why would I go to a club with someone that doesn't fuck with me?
Guys, we're all friends now. Come on, bro.
You're so mad, bro.
Go to the club.
I don't, but it doesn't mean you can't.
It doesn't mean you can't be chill.
You can still be a
club. Well,
that's just weird,
though. No, it's not.
Why would I go to someone that said you don't want to fuck? You don't fuck with me.
Bro, we're chill. Everyone's chill.
I know.
Just come.
Right.
You'll make it up in the club. You'll make it up in the club.
They both left to the club, and then one of my homeboy was like, yo, bro, expose his ass, bro. Like, that shit's not right, bro. And then I was like, all right, bet. I turned on the live, went live on Twitch. I talked about the whole situation. It was tight. He seen it. The whole time he was on live, he was just getting cooked by his own viewers. His own viewers was talking mad shit about him. And then all he did was just stay quiet.
Even during the 1v1, his own viewers was cooking him. Correcting the score, even when he tried to cheat the score. Man, Nick, that was a sorry way to go out, man. Fucking hell, bro. All I can say is, Nick, this is cider. If anyone was.
Quiet and just act like nothing happened, smiling fake.
All I can say is, boy, you gotta take, like I said, you gotta take a sabbatical. Think about life, go on a spiritual journey. Shave your hair, go bald. Become a monk. Delete all socials. Open your third eye. Feel me? Become a guru. Come back. Help people become spiritually enlightened or some shit. I don't know. Like, you gotta think of something. I don't know. Go create a car brand. Your own car company. In Japan or some shit, or Korea. Yo, I'm saying, bro, you could be that nigga in Korea.
Yeah, keep smiling, like, fake ass smile, trying to hide his shit. He was on Twitch talking about, like, I'm gonna kick his ass out, bro. I was like, bro, what the fuck? I was like, I don't trust him. My brother called me on stream talking about, like, yo, bro, you good? I was like, yo, bro, could you pick me up? And he drove an hour away from where he's from, Berkeley. He drove an hour away from the school. Pick me up at the night, and I grabbed my stuff And by the way, I recorded the whole trip with my camera, chat. Took everything that I needed, but I left. I stayed at his house, at my brother's dorm. So I went live again. And then I tried recording on this camera. I press record, and then it says SD card is gone. It's removed. You cannot record without no SD card. I was like, what the fuck? Where's my SD card that has all my footage and all this tour? I text the cameraman, yo, bro. Not even 10 minutes later, all I said was, yo, bro. And he was like, you left it here by the computer stuff. But what's your address? Nick's gonna ship it to you. Bro, I put, yo, bro. How would you know what the fuck did I, what I forget to before I left? You left it here. What is he talking about here? He don't even know what I'm trying to text him about. And then I was like, bro, what the fuck? And I was like, respectfully, if anything got deleted.
Wow, that's insane. Foul play. Yo, they're moving snakey over there in that minorities camp. Because that's the minorities camp, feel me? That's where I'm guessing that's how they move. That's your man's, feel me? That's where, like, Nick learned this whole YouTube game. They're moving crazy over there.
It's gonna be a problem. Like, on my camera, my personal belonging. So, he was like, he texted, Nick's gonna delete his footage off it. He doesn't want you with it, but send your address. What the fuck is you talking about? So, they basically admitting that they stole my shit. My personal belonging, my SD card that has 500 gigabytes in that shit. And then they were just trying to, like, gaslight me and shit. Like, talking about, oh, you left it there, you forgot it, bro. Nobody took your shit, blah, blah, blah. And I'm just roll a clip of the cameraman trying to explain how he don't know shit about it and how he didn't steal it.
Hello?
Yo, bro, where you at?
What? I'm driving. San Jose.
You still there?
Yeah.
When are you coming back, bro? Oh, shit.
I ain't gonna lie, you should have checked your camera, bro. On the way there. Just check your camera on the way there. That's crazy. These niggas
probably awesome. Like midnight.
Midnight, yo, bro. Just send me my shit, bro. Huh? Oh shit. Just send me everything, bro. You can do it on the doc. You can do it on the email. What do you mean you don't have the internet?
I'm in a car, bro.
I'm saying, do that shit today, bro. I'm gonna pull up, bro.
If you want, I can just drop your card off to you. Cause it's on the way.
No, bro. Hell no. I want, bro, you could send.
Yo, you see how sneaky this nigga's moving, bro? Yo, this cameraman is just as bad as Nick.
Everything, like all the streaming shit on the email, bro.
You don't want your card?
I want it back too, with all the footage too. But I want everything too. I want all my shit back.
Yeah, I'll just drop her.
Did he delete my shit? Yes or no, bro?
Delete what?
My footage that I recorded.
No.
Cause I remember all my shit, bro. I know exactly, bro. I was there. I mean, serious, bro. No, bro, I'm gonna pick it up at his house, bro. I'm going to his house. I'm gonna pick that shit up myself.
Bro,
with me and my brother, bro.
For a house.
Yes, I'm going. I'm pulling up, bro.
No, you're not, bro.
Yes, I am, bro. You want me to say his address out if you don't believe me?
Bro, we know that you know where we live.
All right, bro.
What's the call? You're not coming to our address.
Yes, I am, bro.
Just drop it off to you.
No, bro, you're not driving.
No, you're not. Off. You're doing all this over a card, bro.
Yeah, and the footage, bro.
Is there.
No, bro, I'm not.
Chill.
I'm not believing that shit, bro.
All your footage is there, bro. What the
no,
fuck?
Bro.
If it wasn't there...
Then why in the text you said...
Hold on, just calm down. Bro, if it really wasn't there, then... None of us would give you the card back, bro. We're giving you your shit back.
Yeah, because it's my card, bro. It has 500 gigs, bro. It's my card. I paid for my shit. Obviously, you would give it back with nothing in it.
We're giving it back to you.
Yeah, and it could be nothing in it, because you probably could delete that shit.
Bro, why would we delete your shit?
Then why would you mention right here in the text saying Nick's gonna fucking delete my shit? You literally said that. You texted me that shit.
No one said that on text.
You said Nick gonna delete his footage off it. He doesn't want you with it, but I'm gonna send your address. You literally said that.
He's talking about the VOD. He deleted the VOD because
Nathan's TOS. Nathan's TOS my ass, bro. Bro was streaming 4 hours afterwards.
The only thing that's deleted is the 12-hour stream VOD, but all the other VODs are on the card.
Wow. Why?
So he deleted it.
Because Nate said it's TOS. Because Nate has his account. And he said he got a strike.
Where's the proof?
Oh, fuck, no, you gotta talk to Nate. But he called us, he was like, it's TOS. Oh, nah. Because Nate has, you seen Nate has,
Why won't you download the footage and then deleted it?
Download what?
12-hour stream and shit. Why won't you download it? I mean, isn't it all...
It's not my footage, bro.
Listen, isn't it all video recorded? It's not just live. It's recorded too, bro.
No, what's it called? The fight? When y'all did the fight in the basketball thing? I didn't record that.
That's cap.
Huh?
That's cap, bro.
No, it's not. We only recorded the bay stuff. Hey,
this is on you, bro. You fucked up.
The bay.
Oh, you recorded everything, bro. I know, bro. You recorded everything, bro.
Bro, this is what's gonna happen.
And listen, why would he take my shit, bro?
All the VODs are already on there, and that's that. We're just gonna go our separate way, bro.
Nah, but why would he steal my shit, bro? Listen, why would he?
No one stole your shit.
Then why is it gone? Why is it gone from my camera?
Bruh, I don't know what to tell you. There's no way we could have went through your shit if we're at a club. We weren't even at that house. You do
what?
We came back. Nick was in the shower, and I was literally outside in the living room with you, and then we left.
But listen though, remember how you gave me that shit back, or Nick gave me that shit back?
I never touched your card, so.
Alright, you probably didn't, but he probably did. Listen, he's the only one that ever touched my card. So, how does this make sense, right? He gave that shit back. I never took my card out ever in my life. So, he took it out. I got it. He gave it back. And I went right back to him with the card asking how you put it. And you, Isaac, literally said, just turn it, like, flip it. And I remember putting that shit... Flipped it and closed that shit and never ever touched my camera, ever touched it, record ever again. And tell me why it's gone. Why is it gone?
Bruh, I don't know. All I know is you left before we ever got back from the club. Like, you left.
Dad, they're not yapping.
We were telling you to calm down. Nick was trying to get you a flight, get you a hotel, whatever. You said you didn't want it. It's cool. But you left. Like, you left fast before we even got back. So I don't know. All I know is I was recording or we were live streaming at the club. We got back. You weren't there. That's all that happened.
Yeah, but why the fuck is my card gone? Why did he steal that shit?
Bruh, no one stole that shit. You probably left it.
No, I didn't. Why would I leave it? I remember putting that shit in the camera. He took it out and he gave it back and I put it in that camera. And I never touched the camera ever again.
Shit, I don't know what to tell you, bruh. But I'm about to start driving. I'm about to get some eat.
And I said, yo, bro, and then... You sent me a whole message saying I forgot my card. Literally, bro. I said, yo, bro, you did not know what I was talking about. And he sent me a whole message.
Well. What's it called? I'm gonna let you know when I get back, but I'm about to go.
Alright, bro, but I better get all my footage and everything, bro. Real shit.
Your footage is there, bro. I checked.
Yeah, but let me guess.
He
checked.
I just put the VODs on the SD card.
Yeah, but...
I don't have that 12-hour stream VOD.
I guess I'm gonna have to do the hard way, bro. Alright. Alright, bro.
Alright, I'm gonna see you.
So, basically, I bought my own flight ticket to go home and everything. Everything was out of my pocket. Like, sure, he tried to say that, don't worry, bro, send your address, send me your name and everything, I'll buy you a flight. He says everything on stream, but guess what? The next day, he never texted me anything. He never double texted. He just sent me one message on stream, and then he never give a fuck after. Fucking cunt. He never give a fuck after, bruh. And then I took a flight home on Sunday. On Sunday night, I took a flight home, and then it was just spam calling me. Before I left, they called me about the SD card. I was like, the cameraman called me. I was like, yo, bro, everything better be sent to my shit, or else I'm, you're gonna get fucked. Pause. And then nigga was like, bro, shut your bitch ass up. He said that trying to act hard towards me on the phone while my brother's next to me, and my brother took my phone out of my hand and crashed out on him. Bro got so scared that my brother will start saying like, yo, we know where you live, bro. Like, we gonna pull up and get my shit back. And then bro got fucking scared and hung up the phone like a bitch, right? And then the next day, later that night, I flew out, you know? And then him and the cameraman, by the way, he blocked me on everything already. Like a day later, before like the incidents, like how we fought and everything, a day later, he blocked me on everything, bro. Yeah. Phone number, YouTube, TikTok, Twitch, everything, every platform, he blocked me on everything, right? So how the fuck are you gonna send me fucking money and shit and say all this shit, but you blocked me on everything, you fucking idiot? So, I mean, it's not like I want his fucking bread, because later that morning when I woke up, like, at my house and shit, right, I got $200 sent to me. You see it right here. And guess what? I send that shit right back because I don't want his fucking money. I don't want him saying like, oh, we paid for it, we paid for you and shit. Fuck you, bro. Fuck you and your money, bro. Just give me my footage, give my everything, my SD card, everything that I recorded and stuff. Give my shit back and the VOD. But the VOD was already deleted that same day. That same day of the 12-hour stream when I left. It been deleted. It's gone. Never coming back. But like two days ago when I streamed, I rolled a clip.
Why would you give me an Addy, bro? Dumbass, say, why would you give me an
Addy? Leaving it right here by this fire hydrant. Bro, what the fuck?
I'm leaving it right here by this fire hydrant.
Bro took my SIM card and put it back now. Let's go see, bro. But you saw someone walking?
Huh?
The cameraman put my shit right here. Out of here.
What?
My SIM card.
What's that?
My SIM card.
They put it right now?
Yeah, but it was the cameraman. I dropped it off right now.
Out of here. What a, that's a bitch.
Man. Probably some dumbass shit, bro. What the fuck? Hell nah. Bro, drop off my shit with a whole envelope and shit, and bro got a case. Man, this shit probably got nothing in this bitch, bro. Real shit. So, bro, this motherfucker took my SD card. He stole it out of my personal belongings. He deleted every single thing on it. Wipe clean. Nothing on it, bro. Wow. Nothing on it. Everything is wiped clean. All right. This is my camera. This is my camera that it took the SD card from. That shit gone.
Let's see if my foot is still in there, bro. Alright. The SD card is open. I don't know how to put it on. Bro, I got my SD card back. He dropped it off. He dropped it off today. Right now, like 10 minutes ago. So I'm gonna see you right now. My footage is fucking gone, bro. Oh, my address. Chat, let's see, bro. I guess he knows my address.
Damn, this.
Let's see all, if all my shit's deleted, bro.
Damn.
I don't know if I put it right. Wow. All my fucking shit got deleted, chat. That shit's crazy, bro. All my footage. Everything's gone. Everything's gone, bro. Yeah, Shrek that motherfucker. Lying on my shit, bro. Even my family vacation, bro. My family vacation that I recorded for memories is gone. Everything me and my friend recorded just for memories is gone. Alright, it's cool if you deleted the content or the vlog that I recorded for myself, my content, that you gave consent to record. You could just delete that. But guess what? You didn't want to delete that. You wanted to delete everything, you fucking bitch. Fuck you. You deleted every single thing. Even my family stuff too, that is for only for memories. And the pictures, bruh. You deleted every fucking thing. Fuck you, bruh. Piece of shit. And you fucking send your cameraman at my house to drop that shit off? Really, bruh? Really? That just shows a lot, bro. You fucking fake motherfucker. Fuck you, bruh. Real shit. And yeah, bruh. I just got home. And then guess what, chat? After all the exposing video, all the shit I exposed him for, motherfucker put his shit on private. Every social media, everything is on private. His comments on private. And guess what? Watch. The only thing he'll come back to is the fucking apology videos. I'm not accepting your apologies, bitch. Straight up, fuck you. Fucking bully. You got bullied, bitch. Fuck you. Pussy ass. Even though you assault me, I'll still beat your ass still. You want round two? Come and get round two, bro. The fuck? But yeah, though, bro. You got your shit cooked. Use your fucking hands, chat. Use your hands, alright? And that's all I gotta say. Use your fucking hands.
That's crazy, bro. The nigga deleted all his footage. L, man. L, bro. That nigga's L. Yo, everybody go support Say, bro. Everybody go support Say. Right now. Go support Say right now. Run and shut up.